Hi, my name is Nathan Allcraft. I'm with Keysight Technologies. I'm here at IMS 2024 down on the demo floor, showing off some of the latest capabilities we have with our design tools. There's a lot to talk about, but there's two things really special that I want to show you right now. The first is our 3D heterogeneous integration capabilities in ADS, and the second is going to be a lot of the Python AI ML work that we're doing. Let's start with the 3D HI capabilities. I have a quick example that I can show you with ADS right now. This is a full assembly. This is a mimic on top of a package on a board, bond wired up together. This was created in ADS just by dragging and dropping these different things together. These are different technologies, something that requires a lot of automation to support, and no other tool has this capability right now. Once we bring this capability together, we now have full analysis capabilities to our RF Pro tool. Let me show you what that looks like. I bring up this structure in RF Pro, and immediately you can see some of the things that we have today. We have full 3D component support. We can download these from any of the component vendors out there. We are supplying encrypted models as well. So if you have a vendor that has encrypted components, we support that. You can load them up, bring them into your design environment. You see the full assembly that we have, pads to the bond wires down up to the mimic. And one of the things that's special about RF Pro is that if I zoom into this thing, this is a full hierarchical design with multiple technologies. I zoom into this, and you can see right in the middle of it, we have an active device. Normally, you would have to go and make a copy of your design. You would have to delete the active device, add your pins in, do your EM simulation, bring those results back into a schematic level, wire everything back up, and then you can do your full co-simulation. RF Pro, no more, it automates this whole flow for you. I just go through here. I can select my component model that I have that I'm not going to EM. I can tell it what type of model I want to use. This could be a PDK model that's supplied by the foundry. I could create my own lump model representation. I could take in measure data. You could pull down vendor libraries that you could use for this. And once you have this full thing set up, you run the simulation. And at the very end, after the simulation is run with all the passive data, you simply go and you generate your subcircuit right out of RF Pro. And that creates this schematic. This is where everything is automatically tied together for you, the user. And this block here represents the EM data of the board, the package, the bond wires, and all the interconnect on that mimic, wired together through name to the actual active device that we've specified in RF Pro. One button, less than a second, and this whole co-simulation is set up for you automatically. This simple plot shows you exactly what you get when you run this full-level 3D analysis capability. This red line, this is the just this mimic by itself, the full schematic of the mimic. The blue line is now the EM co-simulation of the mimic with that one active device. And you see that lines up pretty good when you look at it just the mimic by itself. But now take that mimic and you put that on the package, and this aqua line shows the degradation and performance of that mimic in the package. Take that one step further, put that on the board, and you can see further degradation. So by being able to incorporate more of the realistic operating environment effects that you have in your design, you get a full better understanding of how that design is going to work in the real life. So that is one great thing that we have to talk about today. The next thing I want to highlight is some of the AI machine learning capabilities that we have. This is a hot topic across the industry, and there's things that we're doing right now today with that inside of ADS. So let me step back and show you that. First, I talked about the 3D HI already, but AI machine learning, there's three main areas that we're focusing on right now. First is the 6G research. We're working at the universities now to develop this, and we're incorporating that into our 6G analysis flow today. We're also working with the Python AI machine learning automation. This is opening up a Python code environment to everybody that's using ADS. We have integrations now with our neural net modeling capabilities that the users can run today, and this is going to be fully released with the ADS 2025 release come July. And finally, the load pull ANN. This is something that we've been working on for a while. This is a great capability. This is a Python-based interface that you can install with ADS. It reads in measured load pull data. It automatically filters out the bad data points for you from the measurement. It regrids the data, and then it will do an ANN model extraction for you. That you can then take that ANN model and plug it into ADS or plug it into SystemView to use for simulations. That's taking measured load pool data to simulatable model in just a couple of mouse clicks. This is some great AI capability that we have that we've available to you right now today. Thank you for your time.